and they cannot have any distractions. So please, no talking.
Chess players can't win games unless they know what their opponent is thinking.
The first crisis came suddenly and very early on.
Rook 12, Kasparov plays queen a5 check again.
Ah, looks like a repetition.
Because when I come here, you know,
Kasparov, as black, played a tricky defense against two of his opponents, attempting to neutralize their advantage as white.
Is this a move here, like hitting the bishop and preparing?
He offered them a choice, kind of a psychological dare, either to play on into unknown and difficult territory or repeat the position, thus forcing a draw, ending their games after only 10 moves. It caught everyone by surprise.
White has the choice. In other words, he gave these two Americans the choice of whether or not they want to take a draw with him. But if they do, they're wasting a white, leaving their teammates, in effect, with black and Kasparov with less worries to think about. And also, it's like a psychological dare. You don't want to take a draw with white. You're supposed to have the advantage.
Fishbein chose to play on and found himself in a totally confusing position. Edelman had to make his own decision.
When the world chess champion offers you a draw, do you play like a hero and you try for the win and you get clobbered, or do you take a draw? I decided to take a draw. Is there something wrong with that?
No, I don't want to do this, for instance. You have black, you have white, you have to play. This is my opinion. Sorry. It's not a game. You have white and you play against world champions. Your only chance.
He was the one who initiated the draw. He made the repetition, which forces white to either take the draw or play some unclear line, which I don't believe gives white an advantage. So I was hoping that he'd play better, but he didn't. He gave me the draw.
You made a hard, bad mistake, yes. Because when I was young, I couldn't miss the chance to play against world champion, even a known position. If you think that this result is much more important for you than the game, sorry. But I withdraw. Ask Abbott. It's unfair.
Gary Kasparov was upset that the Danny Edelman agreed to the draw because he genuinely loves the game.
So true.
and he wants to play the game. For him, it's more important to play the game than to score a result. For my part, I never at once considered accepting the draw.
The same thing happened on Fishbein's board. Alex Fishbein chose to play to win. And we'll see how smart that decision was. We'll see how well he does in the future.
And I suddenly realized that my idea was, which is wrong. I sat at the board for about 45 or 50 minutes trying to figure out what the hell I could do.
Well, at some point he's gonna have to take this pawn, or he's just gonna be a pawn down.
Yeah.
First impression is that this is good for Kasparov.
When I'm playing a game, and if I'm just worse, I make it my challenge to hold the position. Because if you've had this really horrible position, and if you can convince yourself, well, it wasn't me, it was just this act of God that created this horrible position, and then he put me down and I held it against impossible resistance, you know, it's a good feeling. And that's the kind of attitude that you have to get yourself into for holding a bad position. I found my best chance was to attack on the king's side to distract him from what was going on in the center of the board.
Wolf played a surprise move, queen h6, threatening mate.
Oh, well, I certainly didn't see that.
Kasparov responded by h4.
So Kasparov avoided that, he simply played h4, maintaining pressure on this guy.
He sat at the board for about 10 minutes, found a very interesting, very complicated defense, which he undoubtedly calculated about 5 or 6 moves deep.
But the definite impression is that Kasparov will easily find a defense to this stuff. Not that the attack is that weak, but that White is going to find a way. Surely Kasparov will find a way.
Let's look for a way. Knight d5, bishop c5.
Okay, you want to look for a way.
Not only was it a complete turnaround, but at the same time, it was a completely unbelievable sequence of moves. It was the logical idea in the position, which I developed as best as I could, but the resulting positions were just amazing.
At this point, it had become very serious. Kasparov realized that he might actually have to go down in the Wolf game. He wanted to block it out of his mind for a while and move on to the other games. He had some very nice positions on the other boards, but they were going to take some work. Stewart had a completely winning position at this point because Kasparov was letting his pawns just fall off the board without getting anything for it. He was looking for some vague attacking chances, but in terms of the objective analysis of the game, Stewart was winning.
When I play, I'm almost perpetually nervous. And you sort of have to be nervous enough so that you can concentrate, but not so nervous that it destroys your concentration. It's a fine line. And when I'm playing a game and it's going well,